despite being aware of cyber threats. Many oil and gas companies may believe their internal security measures are sufficient, leading to a false sense of security. Welcome to VAR India News Hour. The energy sector is vulnerable to cyber attacks because of its decentralized locations, global supply networks, and gaps between operating infrastructure and IT networks. The potential consequences of a cyber attack, such as operational disruptions, financial losses, and reputational damage, might be underestimated. Some common cybersecurity threats to the energy sector includes ransomware attacks, supply chain attacks, phishing, and exploitation of remote services. Many countries around the world have recognized electrical infrastructure as critical to a functioning society due to its essential role in powering virtually all aspects of modern life. The US government, for example, has designated energy as one of the 16 critical infrastructure sectors which are deemed vital to national security, public health, and economic stability. As a critical infrastructure sector, electrical infrastructure includes power generation, transmission, and distribution systems. These assets must be safeguarded against cyber attacks, physical threats, and natural disasters to ensure national resilience. Global efforts to protect energy infrastructure have intensified as threats evolve, especially in the context of cybersecurity and geopolitical tensions. For instance, energy systems are increasingly vulnerable to cyber attacks, with hackers targeting power grids to disrupt services and potentially cause economic and security crisis. Countries like the US, the UK, and those in the European Union have introduced regulations and policies aimed at strengthening the resilience of their critical infrastructure, with a focus on securing energy supply chains and developing emergency response protocols. In the critical infrastructure sector, particularly energy, there is high cybersecurity awareness due to the sector's strategic importance and vulnerability to cyber attacks. This cautious approach reflects a broader trend in critical infrastructure sectors, where operational technology, that is OT networks, that is for power grids, gas pipelines, and water systems, must be protected from threats that could result in catastrophic service disruptions. Let's look into today's headlines. Google starts rolling out Android 15. Google has officially started rolling out Android 15, the latest version of its mobile operating system, to Pixel devices. The new operating system brings a lot of new features that make smartphones safer, more private, and more user-friendly. This update is rolling out to eligible Pixel phones and tablets. One of the features of Android 15 is the new private space for apps, which is perfect for anyone who wants to keep certain apps like social, dating, or banking apps private. The government to launch 3 AI Center of Excellences for healthcare, agriculture, and sustainable cities. The Union Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan has announced 3 artificial intelligence centers of excellences that is focused on healthcare, agriculture, and sustainable cities. The COEs will be led by top educational institutions in consortium with industry partners and startups. The COE in healthcare will be led by IIT Delhi and AIIMS, while the COE in agriculture will be led by IIT Ropar. The sustainable cities COE will be led by IIT Kanpur. Samsung India workers call off over a month-long strike. Following the resolution of the issues and the management announcing several welfare measures, the workers' strike at Samsung India's plant near Chennai has been finally called off. A statement by the Tamil Nadu Labour Department said that after instructions from Chief Minister M.K. Stalin and other ministers, officials from various departments conducted meetings with concerned parties. It was then decided to call off the strike with immediate effect and resume work. Intel and AMD come together to counter rising competition from ARM. Intel and Advanced Micro Devices, that is AMD, have announced forming a group to help make sure software works across their chips. This is also in response to address the rising challenge from ARM holdings. Intel invented what is known as the x86 computing architecture, while AMD licenses the technology from Intel and also makes chips using x86 competing directly against Intel under a long-standing legal settlement. Prime Minister Modi reiterates his vision to provide the world with a fully made in India phone. At the ongoing India Mobile Congress, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that India has become a smartphone manufacturing hub, with the world now viewing the country as a mobile exporter. During his inaugural speech, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said that while in 2014 there were only 2 mobile manufacturing units, but today that number has grown to over 200. The Prime Minister also recalled that a decade ago he laid out the vision of a digital first India, aiming to lower the cost of phones. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VAR India magazine. You can download the VAR India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for more news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.